Hey guys, welcome to this short introduction video where I will showcase you how the Vizlib Writeback Table works and how easy it is to set it up. The Writeback Table offers a rich set of functionality covering multiple use cases, but one of the most amazing things about it is it only takes 2 minutes to set it up. Let me show you how. Start off by creating a new sheet in practically any app you want. You don't need any special data, just your normal data model will do. Add the Vizlib Writeback Table to your sheet, which you will find on the left-hand side under Vizlib Collaboration. You will see it offers two options. Click on Setup to pop up our three-step configuration wizard. Step 1 is about setting up your data connection and specifying your file name. This is where the edited data will be written back to. You can choose between QVD, CSV, text file formats, more advanced destinations such as REST connectors, and very soon database connections are available too. Here's also where you define the operator type, defining how the data is written back to your data source. For more on operator types, visit our documentation. Step 2 is about defining your table structure. Browse your data model and add dimensions, measures, and define your writeback fields in a very user-friendly way by using very simple drag and drop. In here, you can choose from one of 13 different data input types and also define which fields are editable and which fields remain read-only. You also have the flexibility to rename your fields in the data model, make sure that they are unique, and then, once you're happy, move on to the next step. The last step is about loading writeback data back into your app. This is to ensure a smooth user experience for your users. By clicking on this button, you inject the script you see here, which will be automatically added into your data load script. Make sure you're not working on a published app. Alternatively, copy the proposed load script to your clipboard and paste the snippet where you see it fit into your load script at any position you like. The only thing you gotta make sure is that this part of the load script gets loaded. And that's it. Click on Done, Save, and let's go. The writeback table will get initialized, and that's it. You can now start writing back. Type in your words, your comments, give your countries a score, and once you're done, click on the writeback button. A tiny warning message will indicate the data source QVD file does not exist, which is not a problem. It will be created as part of the first writeback. You can now continue your prototyping journey by adding more input fields, such as the switch. Any new columns that you're adding will automatically be included in the data source destination. There's nothing for you to worry about. That's how dynamic this is. You can freely edit any data you like. Either one column, a whole row, or even if you want to, you can completely add a whole new row into your table. No extra configuration is needed. A writeback table takes care of that, and any input will be stored right away and loaded back into your data model. In this mini example, we're adding a new row, a new country, Barbados, a place I always wanted to go. We give it a score, we put on the switch, and when we're done, we're writing back multiple edits in one go. As you see here, the edits were being kept, and as you go to the next page, you see also the new row was added. That's writeback for you. What's also interesting is the ability to trace and audit who has done which changes. We're capturing the username and a timestamp in the data source as well. Let's add a Vizlib table and include all edited fields that we've changed, plus the audit fields. You see here, they're loaded as part of a data model. All I do is I click on them, add them, and if you look here, a table has been created, which shows all the details of my changes, when they happen, and who has done them. Vizlib Writeback is a powerful solution that helps you expand the number of use cases that you can solve with Qlik Sense. More importantly, with Vizlib Writeback Table, creating a use case is very, very easy and very quick to set up. For more information, an example, and more video tutorials, please visit our website or our YouTube channel.